This is the Snake River Canyon near Twin Falls, Idaho. Looking north here, nice little waterfall just below the Mermaid Pool. And the Prime Bridge, can't see it, but it's maybe about a mile or so to the west of us. And this area has really great evidence from the Bonneville Flood. I have a nice video on the channel that talks all about the Bonneville Flood. So if that's a story you're not familiar with, I'd go there first and get the history and the full story before going any further. So we have in this area here, around Twin Falls, is where two channels or paths of the Bonneville Flow merge together in the canyon, providing extremely high amounts of energy and turbulence during the peak of the Bonneville Flood. As we move to this area, a mile or so west of the Prime Bridge, the canyon actually widens out a little bit, and the Bonneville Flood, as it was waning, was able to deposit and drop some of these large boulders in this area. So you can see these big boulders. In some places, they're in excess of maybe like 3 or 4 meters in diameter. Typically, they're somewhat rounded, so these rocks were all, these huge boulders were transported by the Bonneville Flood, banging into each other, and that's what created their rounded shape. Mainly basalt, although we do see a little bit of rhyolite in here, which was excavated from the canyon just between here and Shoshone Falls. And big boulder fields, these boulders are actually called melon gravels. They have kind of a fun little name. We see boulder fields like this here, down in Buell, Hagerman, King Hill, Swan Falls, and Celebration Park, all sorts of paths along the Snake River, wherever the canyon widened out enough to deposit these rocks. But what I want to do here is spend some time looking at kind of a mystery, and I'd like you to help out if you can, because most of my videos I have kind of figured out the geology, or I've looked at a geologic map or read some literature, done some research, so that the story's pretty well known, and it has a nice little red bow on it, and it's pretty easy to show it and explain it in a, hopefully an engaging way. But here today, what I'd like to do is show you a feature in this canyon that has me a bit perplexed. And I do have an interpretation or a hypothesis on how it formed, but I'm not married to that idea, and I'm definitely open to some other ideas as well. So let's start with the canyon wall. So over here, we've got the south rim of the canyon, and we can see these big talus fields, these big, so there's big boulders over there as well, but they're very angular. So those rocks are what we call, those are from rockfall. So the rockfall events off the canyon rim, probably in the last, you know, couple of thousand years or so, or what are depositing all those rocks out there. And then as we get down here into the valley of the Snake River, we start to see more of these big rounded boulders that are evidence for the Bonneville Flood. Again, on the north side of the river, more talus slopes, rockfall, that sort of thing. But everything kind of has a typical size here. Like the biggest blocks you find in here are maybe up to 10, 12, maybe pushing 15 feet or so, and that's about it. And so if we head over here, we'll start to look at one of these features that kind of has me perplexed a bit. There's kind of a mystery going on, and that's this big outcrop here. Now, this is basalt. All these basalts were lava flows at one time from local volcanoes, but this outcrop is quite massive. I'm looking at the width of it here, and it's probably 50, maybe 60 feet in this dimension, kind of north-south. And if we get down here to the trail, there's a little easier walking here down to Auger Falls with the mountain bike trails. We can come around to the south side of this interesting outcrop, and it's probably 30, 35 feet tall, but the east-west dimension of it from that end to that end is probably approaching maybe 100 feet or so. At one point I did measure these, so hopefully you can just buy my estimates for now. In fact, it's so big that a few years ago I actually put, I developed some routes in here, so you might be able to see some of the bolts and anchors down here for rock climbing. But what's interesting about this big rock, and there's a couple other in the area as well, I sort of informally call these megablocks, for lack of a better term. And what's interesting about these is their orientation. And so if we get back here and look at this thing, you should probably be able to pick out some fractures or some lines running through it, more or less in this direction, sort of steeply dipping to your right, which would be to the south. And as we get up here a little bit closer, we see that the fractures run that way. Here's a nice fractured surface here, but the vesicles, the gas bubbles in the rock, are also running in that direction as well. You can see a couple up there in the shadows. Let's see if we can find another little spot here. Yeah, so, and if you know anything about lava flows and how these gas bubbles kind of work typically, is the gas bubbles will tend to be on the top of the lava flow. And so, and these lava flows, just like along the canyon rim over there, are largely horizontal. So as these volcanoes are erupting, they're filling in topography, but they're creating layers of rock that are pretty close to horizontal. And here we have layering in this rock that's definitely at a steeper angle. So I'm gonna take you up top and we'll see if we can gather some more data before we make any definitive conclusions. So kind of backing up from it here, looking to the east. Again, you can kind of see these, the layering. There's areas of rock that are more eroded, ribs of rock, but the layering is running more or less like this throughout it. The other interesting observation is you can see that some of the surfaces are quite rounded and form very smooth shapes. In fact, this bolted route here with all these kind of little bulges in it, I ended up naming that Ride the Wave, because the rock itself reminded me of kind of like waves in the ocean. So let's head up top and see what some of these other big mega block outcrops look like, and maybe make a few other observations, and then I'll give you my 2-cent hypothesis on how these formed, and maybe you'll come up with something better, or maybe you'll be able to tweak that a little bit. So let me work my way up this cliff face. Sorry about the lousy camera work there. Okay, so now we're working our way along the top, and we can see in places the surface is quite smooth on top. So there's been some sort of erosional agent smoothing out the surface of the outcrop here. And then once we're on top, we can see there's sort of a field of these mega blocks. There's one right here, one down here, one just past it in the distance, another one down here, and then just to the right of that tree in the distance is another big one. Here's a great spot here where we can see the chain of vesicles. So the bubbles sort of going in alignment, more or less east-west. And then there's one more thing I wanted to show you up here. If you know a little bit more about how basalt works as lava, you know that it has some characteristic textures. And so a lot of times when lava is hot and has low viscosity as it pours out of the ground, it creates a ropey texture called pahoehoe. And right up here on top of this slab, we have some beautiful pahoehoe texture, again, lining up with this slab here, this about, you know, 60, 70 degree dipping to the south slab. Some rock climbing anchors. Yeah, and you can actually see again the chain of vesicles forming a line that you can actually trace out all the way across the entire outcrop here. Smooth surfaces. So that's some of the data here. My interpretation is that possibly during the Bonneville flood, a huge section of the cliff, as the flood was undercutting and eroding the slopes below the cliffs, a big section of the cliff, maybe on that side or maybe on the north side, I really don't know, failed, slid down into the canyon, was too big to be moved by the Bonneville flood, but because it kind of fell into water, it didn't break apart. Notice that when we get rockfall over there, The rocks just break apart into much smaller pieces, and yet we have this huge intact piece. So it moved down to the bottom of the flood, the bottom of the canyon, where, and the flood was still raging, and it sat here for some time as the flood continued getting sandblasted, creating these smooth, polished surfaces on the rock here. And so that's my idea, is that these represent a big slide or rockfall event during the Bonneville flood. They're at different orientations. Some of them are tilted this way, some are tilted in other directions. So maybe you have some good ideas, but that's the mystery of the mega blocks here in the Snake River Canyon near Twin Falls, Idaho. Love to hear what your suggestions are.